Hi Emily, how are you? Wow, how good is it to be back at our old school? It's like we've never left.
Great to see you, Kayson. Can you believe it's 50 years today since we left Highcliffe? I'd like to say you don't look any different, but I think we both know our surviving.
Speak for yourself. You're the youngest drop here often. I thought I'd see you on your own.
Yeah, I'm my youngest. Always very busy. Not interested in me talking about our time here.
Oh, Emily!
Kayson.
Sorry I'm late. There was a delay in my flight and I couldn't find a taxi. Gosh, this place doesn't change, does it?
Hi everyone. Happy 50th Leavers anniversary. Happy days, especially the last. Oh, hi Ayo. We had it tough here, didn't we? I couldn't wait to go, remember.
It's the hard knock life for us. It's the hard knock.
He's
right. He's right. We might have your memory somewhere, Whistle. We had such a great time. Don't you remember?
I remember in year two, we were allowed to bring in cards and fidget spinners, and each day me and my friends would bring on stacks and stacks of cards, but I didn't have a fidget spinny. So, I got sad, so I got one, but some people would fight with the fidget spinners and hurt each other, so they got banged. And so with the cards.
My favourite memory from reception was when I spilled the blue glue down my t-shirt. My mum has to come all the way to school to get me a new one.
I remember in year one, when if someone got kind Kevin, they would choose someone who was kindest to them throughout the week to get kind Kevin next. I remember in year one when, during golden time, Florence fell asleep and I put her in the reading corner.
In year two, I remember when Miss Witherford forgot to bring her hamster into school. Everyone was so disappointed.
Our favourite memory of year one was when Mrs. Halford fell off her chair in front of everyone.
Reception, Tekka and Ayo were making things out of Lego.
They found a piece of Lego that they both wanted, so they had a fight over it.
Whenever in year two, Miss Kilpin called us noggin as a joke.
My favourite memory from reception is when I spat all the milk over Mrs. Gutter and she really didn't like it, so went all over our shoes.
So you can't call that a hard life?
Well, yes, I do remember. Those things were good. We had some great teachers, didn't we?
Remember Mr. Mack and Miss Cliff?
Yeah, they were great. What a brilliant start to school we had.
But now I think about it, they were the only good things we ever did. After year two, nothing. Key says she was miserable, miserable.
She's losing her mind. Do you remember year three and four were great? Remember?
In year three, I remember when we made a volcano and we put cooker mentors in it and it made a huge explosion.
I remember in year four when we had Mrs. G and we learnt to play violin, viola and cello.
I remember in year four when we went to battlefields. My favourite part was when we had a Viking fight.
I could remember in year four, all of them with this bunny had an argument.
Which was a competition.
In year three, while the year sixes were at their trip, we had an activity week, and one of the activities was to make Pokemon cards.
And George made loads so that he could trade them.
I remember in year three when we used Coke Mentors as an experiment to then pour into a volcano.
We made the volcanoes out of paper mache, and trust me, it got very messy.
I remember in year four the pencil flinging was invented by Wissam, me, George, Rohan and also Oliver.
This is how you do it.
Year three we made a huge Viking ship to fit the whole class on. I couldn't believe we made it that big.
Miss Wissam and Miss Witherford would be horrified if you forgotten all that.
Okay, I'll give you that. They did arrange some great activities. I learned a lot about the Romans and the Tudors during those years. Things I've still not forgotten to this day.
Of course you did. Highcliffe was a great place. So good for schools nowadays.
Yes, they don't know they're born today. The way they made us work during those years, it never stopped. This test and that essay, they made us clean the building before we went home at night. I made method and dungeons for them to serve. I knew what they were up to.
He gets worse every year. Really loved it this time, though.
Yes, you're right. Year five and six are hard work, but you remember all the fun stuff we got to do. Remember.
I remember in year five when we wore pyjamas and we brought in sweets and we had to clean it all up after.
I remember when we went to the outdoor pursuit centre and we were doing paddle boarding and I lost my paddle. So I went under the bridge, tried to quickly swim with my hands to get it.
I remember in year five when Mr. Patel gave Serena the name Serena the Daydreamer because she always used to enter her own world.
I remember when we did four schools and on the last week we did a water fight, but no one can get to him because he was so fast.
Yeah. Our favourite memory of year five was when Olive, Dia and Olivia got told off
for doing absolutely no work.
In year five, drawing young voices, some people were lining during lunch and Grace thought that she was supposed to line up too. This was also during switching classes, so we were in Mr. Patel's class. We went into Miss Beswick's class and started singing. Grace was confused because she didn't do young voices.
People said to go outside because I wasn't supposed to be there, so finally I did, and I went inside Mr. Patel's class and I just stood there for nearly 10 minutes because I couldn't see anyone else outside playing, even though they were. Finally, when our class came inside, everyone looked confused and I just sat there embarrassed for the rest of the day, even though no one really knew what happened.
Miss Murphy swore once when reading the book trash because it was in the book.
When we were at the Outdoor Pursuit Centre, Kenny and Salem jumped onto everyone's paddle boards
and flipped them over, including Miss Mason's one.
The first lockdown was a time that we've all never forgotten, all the online learning, all the boredom.
Oh yeah, I remember that. At least the weather was good.
What a time to be alive.
Do you remember the changes after that? We had to go in our separate bubbles.
We had so many ambitions, didn't we?
Yes, all those changes is obviously what some people want to do.
When I'm older, I want to be a professional tennis player.
When I'm older, I want to be a professional baker.
When I'm older, I want to be a scientist who makes machines. When I'm older, I want to be a mechanic.
When I'm older, I would like to become a vet and open up my own clinic.
When I'm older, I want to be a cricketer.
When I'm older, I want to be a best-selling author.
When I'm older, I want to be a scientist.
When I'm older, I want to be a policeman.
When I'm older, I want to be a gymnast.
Well, we all knew Rosie would make a good singer when she sang Frozen in year one.
Yeah, but to be in Young Voices, that's pretty special.
But there was a million other awards.
Well, it doesn't matter about being famous, does it? Do you remember what all the teachers told us?
Of course we do.
They said we could achieve whatever we put our minds to and that whatever we do, we should be happy and healthy.
A good message. It was a good school. I do miss it.
We worked hard here and had fun, full of happy memories. It was a sad but exciting day when we left.
Looks like it's time for me to be off. You two okay getting home?
Yes, I've got my place in the bus pass. Never let me down yet.
I'll be fine. I've got a return flight home in a few hours. Yeah, we must go up to the moon and see your place soon.
Yeah, you should. It's so tranquil. Don't think I'm mad, but I almost hear it singing on the last day again.
I'm moving on.
from pride. Each friend there to make a smile on a rainy day. You say you say it's our sleeping place. You say we run too fast. We don't want to leave this too soon. Sure, our memories will last.
Year 6, we just want to say a massive, massive thank you for being so unbelievably fantastic this whole year.
We have just had the best time. As you know, it was my first time in Year 6, Miss Mason's first time in Year 6, and you have been incredible.
We honestly miss you so, so much. It was so emotional. You have been my first ever class, not even just in Year 6, but ever. You are my first class, which means I'm going to remember all of you for such a long time. Thank you for making me laugh every day. Thank you for your silliness. And thank you for trying your absolute best. It meant the absolute world to me.
I'm so proud of you, my class. Watching you grow from those tiny little year fours I had to who you are today, you are so, so ready for secondary school, and I cannot wait to hear how you've been getting on.
Thank you so much, guys. We'll miss you.
Bye, we'll see you soon.